And marketing automation is one of my favorite topics, because marketing automation is something that is going to be, you know, helping you make money on automation without having to do anything. So I will go ahead and switch off the chat for a while so that we can focus on the webinar. And then once in a while, when I'm asking for feedback, I will ask you to go ahead and chat. And also, this is a free webinar, and I'm not going to waste much time introducing myself or anything. You already know about me. A lot of people are here. And I will just go ahead and focus on the lesson so that you can focus on it. And I know that a lot of people here are already part of my internship program, and the rest of the people are probably wanting to join the internship program, but you don't know about the internship program yet. So how many of you here want to join the internship program? And if you have heard about it and you want to join, just type me in the chat box. All right. So I see a lot of people here who have not joined the internship program yet and want to join the internship program. So wait for my launch webinar. For that, I will be doing one more launch webinar in which you will get details about the program, and you can join there. All right. So I will be sharing you an application form with you, which you have to apply, and then you have to get approved for it. And I see a lot of people are from my previous internship batch, and a lot of people have already joined internship batch 4. So this webinar is going to kind of give you an idea about what is the kind of content that you can look forward from me, and what is my teaching style and things like that. So now let's get started with the class. So imagine that you have a personal army, and you have a personal army of people who are ready to listen to your commands, and they are ready to do whatever you say. How amazing it would be. You can go and ask them to do marketing tasks, and you can go and ask them to do sales tasks. And imagine that your personal army is going ahead and doing sales for you and bringing in the sales, and you continuously make money out of it. How amazing it would be, right? So that's what we are going to have a look today. But in a practical sense, you cannot have an army. And if you are a Star Wars fan, you might have seen the clone army. You know, there is this clone army where all the stormtroopers are ready to, you know, help the Darth Vader and the enemy to go ahead and attack people. So what we are basically looking at in marketing automation, and marketing automation is very powerful, is that we are looking at an army of robots. And imagine, instead of a real human army, you have an army of robots who are ready to help you. All right. And the army of robots are ready to help you to go ahead and do sales for you, send messages to customers for you, and they are also ready to go ahead and take the payments, deliver the products. And imagine you have, you know, 1,000 people robot army. How amazing it would be. You know, that is the kind of mindset I want you to have. You need to have an army so that the army can work with you. And you see that there are a lot of people who have very big companies, and you have very big sales teams in those companies. Like they have like 500 people working in a call center, and all the 500 people are like calling different people and trying to sell a credit card, like a insurance, or you might have got calls from real estate companies and all that. And this is very inefficient, right? You have to pay these humans, and these humans are also inefficient, and sometimes they don't do a good job. But imagine that you have like 500 robots who are doing it for you, and they are doing it as expected. They will not require a lot of salary. They don't need a place to stay. They don't need food, or they don't need medical insurance, health insurance, or anything like that. And you can have this army communicate with your prospective customers and convert them into clients. How amazing that would be. We all want that, right? And we talk about automation. We talk about you know, the robots, self-driving cars, the robots coming as and doing household works. Nowadays, we have automated robots which clean the house. You have self-driving cars in the US which are driving themselves. And we have all this automation, right? But when we think of robots, we think like a humanoid robot. Like, you know, I'm sure that you have watched iRobot movie. And in iRobot movie, there is like a humanoid robot which is, you know, trying to help people go around, do tasks, buy groceries, clean the house. But in a practical sense, why are the robots as seen in the movies not here in the real world? That's because it's very inefficient to create such kind of robots who can move around and everything. And right now we have Boston Dynamics and everything who are creating such kind of robots for advanced users. But in most of the cases, you don't need robots that look like humans, right? And if you look at so many machines in your kitchen and house, vacuum cleaner is a robot, your oven is a robot, your mixer, grinder, washing machine, these are all robots, right? Except they don't have a face, they don't have arms, and they don't have legs. But what are the kind of robots that will be when these robots are communicating to people and these robots are trying to sell something, these robots are trying to deliver things to customers, and these robots are going ahead and interacting with your customers the way you want, right? These robots actually don't have even a physical form. First of all, they don't look like humans, but they don't have a physical form also, like a washing machine or an oven or a mixer or a grinder. So the robots that I am talking about, who will communicate with your customers, who will do marketing automation for you without you having to do anything, they are hidden inside servers and they are hidden as software, right? And these software codes are in the servers, and it's very efficient, right? You don't need to have large robots walking around, which is made of steel, which has like a battery inside it, which is like made of hydraulic motors and all those things. These robots, which can do marketing automation for you, these robots are hidden inside the data centers and in the servers. So I hope my audio and video is clear. If my audio and video is clear, just type clear in the chat box right now. And I hope you kind of get what I am talking about. You know, I hope you kind of understand that the robots are here, right? Yes, the robots are here. You think that the robots are here, and the robots are ready to do work for you. Yes, so I will close the chat again and I will open it again. Right, so how exciting it is. Are you excited? Just type yes. Just type excited in the chat box. Just type excited in the chat box if you are like super excited to learn how to put these robots to work so that they can make you money. Right, so I will actually show you the techniques of how I do marketing automation also. So let me close the chat box right now and let's get back to this. So now the robots do not understand your language. I cannot go and tell a robot that, hey robot, go and do sales for me. And the robot is not going to do sales for me, right? And robots don't understand your language. They are waiting for your command. This robot army, which is basically software, which is hidden inside the computers, they are waiting for your command. And what we are going to basically learn in this webinar is that we are going to go ahead and learn the language of the robots, which is marketing automation, so that we can tell the robots what to do, so that the robots will go and do it for us. So imagine that if you have an island, if you go ahead and have an island of people, and let's say you discover an island of people and there are 10,000 people in this island, and these 10,000 people are ready to work for you, and these 10,000 people are ready to go ahead and do whatever you say. But you can give orders to these 10,000 people and get them to work for you only if you understand their language. Let's say you don't understand their language. Do you think that you can talk to them and give them commands and get them to work for you if you don't understand their language? No, right? Similarly, these robots, which are hidden inside the data centers and the servers, which are basically software, you need to learn how to communicate to them. And that's what we are going to learn in this webinar today. We are going to learn to talk to the robots so that we can give commands to them. And that's what marketing automation is all about. And if you learn how to communicate, you have like an unlimited army of robots. Like, you know, it could be 10,000, 20,000, 1 lakh codes running for you day and night without you doing anything. And right now, as I am talking to you in this webinar, my robots are working for me. My email automation robots are sending emails. My SMS automation robots are sending SMS to people, and they are doing it for me, and they are doing it in my name. In fact, they are not even going ahead and doing it in themselves. You know, it's like they are doing it in my name as if I am communicating to them. And a lot of people ask me, why did I call myself Digital Deepak? And a lot of people think that I called myself Digital Deepak because I am into digital marketing. But the real story behind naming myself as Digital Deepak is because I am putting a digital version of me out there. right now I may not be digital Deepak. Right now I am the real Deepak talking to you directly on a live webinar. But imagine all the videos that I have posted, all the email sequences that I have written. And if people opt in into my email newsletter, automatically my emails are going out. And it says from Deepak. I'm not going and sending the mails manually. And the automation is taking care of it. So I have created a digital version of me, which is Digital Deepak. And the Digital Deepak is going ahead and sending out all these messages to people. And people feel like I'm communicating to them directly. And that is how I have built my influence. That is how I have become the personal brand that I am today. And today, if you look at, you know, there are 3,000 people live on this webinar and the room has filled. A lot of people are trying to get into this webinar and they are not able to enter the webinar because the rooms are filled. And I have got you into this webinar because I have been sending you emails on automation. And once you have subscribed for my free digital marketing course, you would have continuously got emails from me without me doing anything. That is because I have set up the marketing automation. That is because I talk to these robots and ask those robots to go and do the work for me. And they are doing the work for me, sending the mails on my behalf as if I am sending it. And these are the emails that you have been receiving from me so far. And once in a while, obviously, I would like to do this live webinar so that you can see the real Deepak. But this is the story of Digital Deepak. So how many of you think that, you know, this is a story that was worth hearing? And go ahead and, you know, put your thoughts in the comments, you know. Do you think, you know, this was like an aha moment for you? So basically, see, marketing automation is not easy. All right. Marketing automation has a little bit of complexity to it, but it's like learning a new language. It's like learning the language of robots so that you can talk to these robots. All right. So that is what we are going to learn today. So I will switch off the comments again. Thanks for the positive comments. So, you know, this is how I think, you know, and you might have seen that before starting the webinar, I put some futuristic music where it's like, you know, futuristic robot times. It's like some Terminator music or something I put. But, you know, a scene like Terminator where the machines will take over and the machine will rule, it will make for good movies. But AI is here to serve us. AI is here to serve us and AI will be our slave. And they cannot think like us. And AI does not have motivation. Only humans have this want of power. You know, only humans want power. Humans want freedom. Humans want love. Robots do not want it. And there is nothing to worry about AI taking over or anything like that. So these robots are ready to, you know, take our commands and ready to work. So they are waiting to partner with you. You are basically partnering with the robot. So gone are the days, you know, old times when you had like, you know, old times. The leverage was human leverage, right? When the pyramids of the Egypt was built, then there was like a king and the king commanded all the slaves to go ahead and build the pyramid. Now we don't have any slaves, but even if you look at 10 years, 20 years back, we had factories and factories had like thousands and thousands of people. And these people had families, they had children, they would fall sick. They would sometimes hurt themselves while they are working. And then you have to provide compensation for them. And these people will sometimes form unions and then they will say, give me more wages and all those. So earlier times, the leverage that people had, you know, whatever you do, you need leverage, right? You know, like for example, if you want to move a big rock, how will you move a big rock? You will place a small rock and you will put a stick and you will push the stick from this end and the big rock will move. That is leverage, right? And we have this famous scientist who said that, if I had a place to keep the stick and if I had a place to stand and if the stick was long enough, then I could move the world. I could move the entire earth. So you are like displacing the entire earth. That is leverage, right? So earlier you had human leverage and when you have like a lot of people working for you, that was human leverage. And then you have time leverage, you have capital leverage, you have many other kinds of leverage in your business. But when you look at the leverage that you are having right now, today it's not the human leverage, it's the robot leverage. You are getting the robots to work for you and the robots will communicate for you. They will do the sales for you. They will do the service delivery for you. They will you know, ask for feedback to your customers for you and all this will happen. And the only reason that you cannot use that leverage and the only reason I am able to use that leverage is because I have learned the language of robots and I have partnered with the robots. I am half Deepak, half Digital Deepak. And Digital Deepak is doing more work for me than I am doing myself. And Digital Deepak is being run by the robots, right? So what we need to do is that we need to learn how to configure the robots. And with the right messages and responses, we are going to configure the robots and we are going to go ahead and get these robots to work for us. So this is the introduction. And now I will go ahead and show you some real case studies of how this works for us and how we are going to go ahead and put the robots to work. And I will show you some really cool automation methods and everything. So before we do that, I hope you liked the introduction of it. I hope you liked the setting constant of it. Yes, you are excited now to think in this angle. Nobody talks in this angle, right? So digital marketing is not just about, you know, Facebook ads and Google ads and all that. And I know it's about a lot of other things, but you need to have like this different view, you know. So let's go ahead and, you know, do something. So go ahead and I will go ahead and share my, so I hope you are part of the Learn Digital Marketing group. All right. So if you are excited to get started with this session, go ahead and comment on this thing. I will go ahead and close the chat again. So go ahead and leave a comment if you are excited to get started, and go ahead and leave a comment. The robots are here. And this is just to create some enthusiasm, and this is just to see how many people are excited. All right. So go ahead and just leave a comment there and just say the robots are here. And just say the robots are here, and other people will be like, what's happening? Like, you know, there are like some 1,000 people commenting here, and people will be like, what's happening here? You know, there is a webinar going about marketing automation, which I am not a part of, and people will have like a huge, fear of missing out. So let's have some fun. So we have 3,000 people in this webinar, and let's see how many comments we can gather. I'm looking at least 1,000 comments. Just go ahead and click on it and go ahead and leave a comment. And I hope you are part of the Facebook group already. So let's see how many people are truly excited to learn today. All right, looks pretty exciting here. So let me go ahead and share a mind map with you. And in the mind map, we will have an outline of what we are going to have a look today. So I'm super excited to share things with you today, and let's get started. So this is what we are going to have a look at today. And basically, this is the outline. All right. So we talked about the age of robots, and we talked about hidden robots being able to do the work for us. We talked about how we are going to speak the language of robots. And you know, one more thing that I want to tell you is that, you know, when you look at sales, you know, everybody needs a sales skill, right? Everybody needs a sales skill. And if you want to, you know, make money, you need to go and have a skill so that you can convert people, you can get people to buy, right? You need to go ahead and, you know, have something so that you need to have a product or a service. And with the product or the service, you are going to ask people for money, and the people are going to pay you money. So earlier, before marketing existed, salesmen used to go from door to door. And I'm pretty sure that you might have experienced door to door salesmen coming to your house and trying to sell you something. Sometimes they will sell kitchen items, sometimes they will sell something. And salesmanship is an art. And you know, everybody in their life needs to go ahead and sell something. And if you are part of my internship program, I actually give exercises where you go ahead and call leads and you actually try to sell to them. And you have like a phone call with the leads. You know, that's one of the exercises I give in the internship program, so that you can have this experience of selling. And a lot of people are afraid of selling. And the only way to get over the fear of selling is that you have to go ahead and just start selling. You know, initially I was afraid of selling. Initially I was afraid of putting myself on camera, putting myself on video, even to create a YouTube video and put my face, I was afraid. But I slowly, and today I am doing a webinar for 3,000 people and I am just cool, I am just calm. And it's like, just like, you know, I'm talking to one friend, like an old school friend who is sitting next to me in a sofa. And that is the kind of calmness I have today. And that is why I'm able to sell very well. You know, with every webinar I do, if I sell a product, if it is a sales webinar, I end up making something like 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs. And this skill will come to you only if you go ahead and try selling. And what we are doing with marketing is that marketing is basically 10x sales. Marketing is basically salesmanship in print. And I always talk about digital marketing. When it comes to digital marketing, it's more about marketing than about digital. A lot of people are like, my Facebook ads I will learn, my Google ads learn karunga, I will learn this, I will learn that. And they just learn all the techniques, but they forget to learn marketing. They forget to learn sales. And digital marketing is not about just posting stuff on Instagram. It's not about, you know, posting links on Facebook. It's not about creating a group or anything of that sort. Digital marketing will work only if marketing works, right? Digital marketing will work only if marketing works. Marketing will work only if sales will work, right? And end of the day, you are using digital marketing to communicate to people in mass. You are attracting people, but these are real people. If you go ahead and meet these people in person, and if you are trying to sell them something, and if they don't buy, even if you are attracting 10,000 people via digital marketing and marketing, they are not going to buy from you. Why would they buy from you? And this is where a lot of people go wrong. They think that they will just become an Instagram influencer. And some people are like just Instagram influencers. They just keep posting something and then they are waiting for a product or a service to endorse them and to sponsor them, because they are waiting for them because they don't have anything to sell themselves. And they are basically, you know, advertising someone else's product. And this is what happens when you have a blog, when you have a lot of products, but I mean, you have a lot of traffic, but you don't have anything to sell. A lot of people might have heard about my bike advice story where I used to run a motorcycle blog. And I was only able to monetize the blog via AdSense. So AdSense or, you know, trying to get advertisement on your website is never a good strategy to make money, because you need something to sell. And that is why I sold my motorcycle blog and ended up creating Digital Deepak. And with Digital Deepak, I'm selling digital marketing courses and I'm selling my internship program. So here there is a profit and I'm selling something to someone. So this is something like a foundation and you need to learn that. So first you need to get your sales fundamentals ready. And once you get your sales fundamentals ready, then you need to get your marketing fundamentals ready. And once you get your marketing fundamentals ready, then you do marketing automation and digital marketing and everything. So marketing is 10x sales. Marketing automation is 10x marketing. And that is how this whole thing works, right? So that is something like a foundational concept that you have to keep in mind. But now let's talk about the Achilles heel of marketing. And I hope you know what Achilles heels means. And Achilles is this character in history where Achilles is like very, very strong. But, you know, there is this myth that his mother, she dipped him inside a pool of water, which was like a holy water or it's like superpower water. And he became immortal. But she held his heel and she put him inside water. But the heel part was not completely immersed in water. So Achilles is like an immortal person. He is like very, very strong. But his heel is the weak point. So that's why it's called Achilles heel. So if you have seen the movie Troy, and if you have seen the history movies or something, if someone, you know, throws an arrow and if it goes and hits Achilles' heel, then the full strong man will die. And that's why we call it Achilles heel. And this term is used in a lot of places. You know, what is the Achilles heel? And imagine if there is a very big ship, it's a very strong ship. And if there is like one small hole in the ship, then the entire ship will sink. So something like that. So there is an Achilles heel of marketing. See, marketing gives you a lot of power. Marketing helps you reach thousands and thousands of people. But imagine that you are in a crowd. Imagine that you have 100 friends and you go ahead and talk to your friends. And when you talk to your friends, do you give the same message to all your friends? You actually give a different message to different friends. You sometimes you have like an old school friend. You might have a girlfriend or a boyfriend. You might have colleagues who are like, you have some politics happening, but then they are also kind of friends. Then your brother might be a friend And do you communicate the same message to everyone? Definitely not. You go ahead and communicate differently to everyone. And imagine you have all your 100 friends and family in a room. And imagine that you are talking to them. And imagine if you are talking the same message to all of them, how stupid it would be. Everybody will get bored, right? So that is the downfall of marketing. That is the Achilles heel of marketing. When you do not personalize your messages for marketing, and when you go ahead and give the same message to everyone, then people are not responding. It's like talking to 100 of your friends in a room and nobody is going to respond. So this is where ad blindness comes in. And you see a lot of ads, like one of the reasons Facebook ads works very well is because Facebook ads, you can target, okay, this age group, this person and everything, but it's still not enough personalization, right? And it feels like you are not hearing something, which is something that is a message. It feels like you are hearing a noise because everybody is sending you the same marketing message and everybody is like, ye le lo, wo le lo, and ye kareed lo. My Hindi is not that great, by the way. My mother tongue is Tamil. Maybe once in a while I can speak in English. So that's what happens, right? When everybody is trying to send you the same marketing message, then you feel like it's noise. You know, you are definitely irritated when you are watching TV and then some advertisement comes. Then you are feeling irritated. Like for example, if you are watching TV and if there is an advertisement for a jewelry brand, let's say Tanishq, and if you are a guy who does not buy jewels, then you will get bored by it, right? Because it's not targeted towards you. And that is the problem with marketing. One-on-one sales will not scale, but marketing ends up delivering the same message to everyone. But when it comes to marketing automation, the power of marketing automation is that you can send a personalized message to everyone at scale. You can send a message to 100,000 people, but 100,000 people will, each and every person will receive a unique message from you. And I will show you how you can personalize messages, right? So that is the power of marketing automation. And marketing automation obviously includes personalization. And you might have received email campaigns where it says, hi, your name. But saying hi, your name is not enough for you to go and personalize it enough. You might have been receiving a lot of email campaigns where it says, hi, name, right? Once it says, hi, name, then it's not going to be enough. It's not going to be enough because name is like everybody calls out the name, but that's not personalization enough. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to show you some techniques where you can replicate your message using marketing automation, but you're also going to personalize your message. So you are going to send messages so that each and everyone feels like they have got like a very, very personal message. All right. So now I will switch on the chat box. So I hope my audio and video is clear. So let me know until this point, everything is clear. Just type clear in the chat box if everything is clear. Fantastic. And I hope everybody is taking notes. Yes. All right. Some people are saying, Deepak sir, why are you so serious today? Okay, I will just not be so serious. All right. So guys, don't take screenshots. Anybody can take screenshots. You need a notebook and you need a pen and you need to write. When you write, it's very healthy for your mind. It's very healthy for your brain because there is a hand-eye coordination. It's very good for your nervous system. You know, I write every day. You know, I have this book. By the way, if you know, Digital Marketing Club, I will be launching it soon. And you need to go and write, guys. You need to go ahead and write. All right. So I hope this makes sense so far. So now let's go ahead and look at some interesting concepts. So now I will switch off the chat again and let me go ahead and talk about personalizing your message. So to personalize messages, you need to gather data for personalization, right? And without gathering data, how are you even going to personalize? So if you have attended my lead generation webinar, I showed you my drip marketing funnel and you might have learned about what is drip marketing and everything, right? So drip marketing is basically a system for going ahead and finding out what are the messages that you want to send in an automation sequence. So let me open the chat box again and you go ahead and tell me how many of you have been receiving drip marketing emails from me. You have been receiving automated emails from me. And once you signed up for the free digital marketing course, you have been receiving the free digital marketing course from me. Yes. So a lot of people might have applied for my internship program as well. Yes, you have applied for my internship program. And if you have not applied for my internship program, type no in the chat box if you have not applied for my internship program. So I see a lot of people who are saying no, but for the people who have not applied for the internship program, you can go ahead and apply at deepak.me/internapply. All right. So I will share this link with you in the chat box and you can go ahead and apply for my internship program. And once you apply for the internship program, what will happen is that you will start receiving a series of messages from me, which is supposed to go ahead and help you nurture. So what happens is that, you know, imagine that I am going ahead and building a relationship with someone. And let's say I'm going ahead and meeting someone at a conference. And once I meet this person at a conference, would I go ahead and become his best friend, even though there is a possibility that I can become his best friend? No, right? If I'm meeting someone at a conference, first I will say hi. First, I will ask them, hey, how are you? What do you do? By the way, I am Deepak. I do this. I'm a digital marketing consultant. And then I will probably get in touch with him after 2 days. I will just message him, hey, how are you? Do you want to get on a phone call conversation? Hey, do you want to meet for dinner? And let's go ahead and talk about it. So if I keep doing this for a long enough time, let's say for 2 months, then will I become a good friend with them? Yes. And usually friendship and relationship happens over time. It does not happen immediately. And that's one of the biggest mistakes that marketers and salesmen do. They try to go ahead and convince a customer to buy their product immediately, even without giving that time to build that relationship and giving that time to get to know each other and making them comfortable enough to buy the product. And here, you know, I'm doing these webinars, I'm sending you emails, I'm giving you a lot of free content because this builds my relationship with you. And that is how relationships are built, right? And one of the best ways to build a relationship is by automation. Like for example, let's say I'm giving my digital marketing tools mastery course for free. And once I give my digital marketing tools mastery course for free, I just don't want people to go ahead and buy my course and forget about it. I want to continuously communicate to them. So here, this is an example of a simple sequence. I will show you complex sequences as well. And this is an example of a simple sequence. And here you can see that I am saying, digital marketing tools mastery, thank you. And I'm going ahead and writing a message to them. And after 3 days, there is another message sending to them. After 3 days, another message is sent to them. After 3 days, another message is sent to them. 3 days, another message is sent to them. 3 days, another message is sent to them. So this is completely automated. So if you go ahead and look at reports, then you can see that these are the emails that I have been sending and you can see the open rate because it is personalized. And I'm sending this email only to the people. So a lot of people think that email marketing is about getting a bunch of email IDs and sending a mail to them. It's not email marketing. That's just like you are standing at a platform and shouting at all the people, hey, buy my stuff, buy my stuff. Nobody is going to care about you. So here, basically, you are communicating to the people because it's relevant. So people who have opted in for my digital marketing tools mastery course, they would want to go ahead and learn from me, right? They would want to go ahead and learn from me and they would want me to communicate to them. So here, that is why the open rates are so high. Like for example, here you can see that I have sent out 18,542 emails and 47.4% open rate is there, which means that out of 18,572 people, around 9,000 people have opened. So here I am talking about two advertising tools for digital marketers, four important tools for SEO, two email marketing tools, three analytics tools, three B2B lead generation tools. So when I continuously keep communicating to people, then people feel like, okay, I know Deepak. And Deepak becomes like a well-known brand. And this is something that is happening on automation without me having to do anything, right? They just enter the funnel once. And once they enter the funnel, the mails are going to them automatically without any problem. And by the way, how many of you already have my digital marketing tools mastery course? Type yes if you already have my digital marketing tools mastery course. If you don't have my digital marketing tools mastery course, type no. So for people who do not have my digital marketing tools mastery course, I will give you a free copy right now so that you can go ahead and subscribe. And once you get my digital marketing tools mastery course for free, so there are going to be 100 tools reviewed in this. And here I'm also reviewing some of the marketing automation tools and you will be able to go ahead. And this course is worth 1,000 rupees, guys. This course is worth 1,000 rupees and I'm giving it to you for free. So I will give you digital marketing tools mastery. I will give you a discount code So discount code is robots. I will just call it robots because today's theme is robots. And 999 rupees discount. And I will just go ahead and give it to you. So you can go ahead and subscribe for this. All right. So I have shared the link with you. And if everybody is trying to click on it the same time, then it will not work. So go ahead and save that link. I will also send this link to you on the chat, I mean on the email, and you will be able to go ahead and subscribe to it later. And once you subscribe to it, you will be able to see that this sequence will start and this sequence will start and this sequence will start sending messages. So let's go ahead and look at, you know, one of the messages inside. And here you can see this is a simple automation. Here I have said subscriber, hello subscriber first name. And there is a simple automation here. It says if subscriber name first name equal to blank, then show this. Else you show this, right? So here I am having custom fields. So these are custom fields. So if there is a first name for the subscriber, then it will say hello first name, or it will just say hello. So this is a simple automation. But I will show you there is a much more complex automation in this also. And what did I tell you? If you need complex automation, what do you need to do? I hope you are taking notes. If you need more complex automation and if you want to go ahead and, you know, have much more advanced communication, what do you need? Can you tell me in the chat box? Let's see how attentive people are today. You need more data. Perfect. Sagar saying data. Ankit is saying data. Monica is saying data. Rishabh is saying data. Fantastic. So you need more data. So how are you going to gather more data? Right? That's what I am going to show you. So you are going to gather more data by asking people to fill an application form, right? And when we are asking people to fill an application form, then we are going to go ahead and gather more data from people. And once we have more data, then we will be able to go ahead and have more personalization in the emails. So let me show you how many of you, like many of you might have heard about Typeform, right? So Typeform is a form which I use for my internship application. So let's say Digital Deepak internship. And this is the application form I have, which is Typeform. And here you can see that I'm asking a lot of questions to people. I'm asking people to apply for my internship program. And I'm asking for their name. I'm asking if they are a student, professional, or entrepreneur. I'm asking, what do you want to do next? I want to get a digital marketing job. I want to become a digital marketing consultant, start an agency, earn from blogging or affiliate marketing, become a digital mentor and sell courses online, grow existing business with the power of digital marketing. So all this I'm asking. And here you can see what are all the topics they want to learn and what is the biggest challenge they have. So that is also I'm asking. Then I'm asking for email ID and I'm asking for an open field and I'm asking for phone number. And then I'm asking for them to confirm their application. So this is how the Typeform is, and I hope a lot of people have already filled it. If you have not filled it, then I have shared the link with you in the chat box. Go ahead and fill it. And here we can see that we have got 7,965 applications. And if you go ahead and look at the summary, you will be able to see this is the distribution we have. So we have 62% students, 22% professionals, and 9.6% entrepreneurs. And these are the goals they have. So let me go ahead and ask you, if I go ahead and send out an email campaign, which is unique for students. Okay, some people are saying the screen is stuck. Let me just share it again. So can you see the screen right now? Clear? Yeah, fantastic. So basically, okay, I'll just go over it again. So basically in the Typeform, so I told you that if you want to send out personalized emails, if you want to send out personalized emails, then you need to gather more data. So I am gathering more data by going ahead and asking people more questions. So if I ask more questions, I will gather more data. So in this form, I've asked for their name. I've asked for their status, which is a student, professional, or entrepreneur. I've asked what do they want to do. Like, you know, get a digital marketing job, become a digital marketing freelancer or whatever. What are the topics they want to learn? And what is their biggest challenge? You know, what is preventing you from achieving your goal to become so-and-so? So here, procrastination, lack of quality and actionable content, lack of guidance and mentorship. So all this we have. And we are collecting all this data. And now, do you think that So let me go ahead and show you the responses. So we have 7976 responses, and let me go ahead and look at the summary. And you can take a minute during the class to go ahead and fill the form. If you have not filled the form already, I will go ahead and share the link with you. And if you want to apply for my internship program, and in my internship program, I go in much more in depth. We have like an entire week allocated for marketing automation. So I have shared the link with you for the survey which I am conducting. And if you fill this survey right now, I will show you how I customize the emails for you and how I can customize the emails for you. So if you have not filled this survey yet, go ahead and fill this survey. All right. So we have 7981, and you can see continuously new applications are coming in. And if I go to summary, you can see that 62% are students, 22% are professionals, and 9.7% are entrepreneurs. And do you think that if I send personalized emails for students, professionals, entrepreneurs, my emails would be better? And I told you about the Achilles heel of marketing, right? If you are sending the same message to everyone, then people will get bored because it's not personal and people will feel like they are being spammed. But if I am sending a different email to each and every person, then wouldn't they feel a little bit better? Okay, this person is talking to me directly. And now there is more personalization. People want to get a digital marketing job, or they want to become a digital marketing freelancer, or they want to earn from blogging and affiliate marketing, or they want to start a digital marketing agency, or they want to grow existing business with the power of digital marketing. And then you have all these things. And then you have 5 different objections. You have 6 different goals. And you have 3 major status, right? So imagine if I have to personalize everything, how many combinations of personalized emails can we send? Can you tell me in the chat box? How many combinations of personalized emails can we send? Not 3, guys, because student, professional, entrepreneur. And then there will be professionals who would want to earn from blogging and affiliate marketing. There will be professionals who would want to grow existing business with the power of digital marketing. There might be entrepreneurs who want to earn from blogging and affiliate marketing. So what is the exact combination? Let's see how many of you know some basic math. What is the exact combination we can have? 3 × 4 × 6. Is it right? It's not infinity, guys. How many combinations are we going to have of personalization? I think it's 3 × 4 × 6. 3 × 4 × 6. So 3 × 4 × 6 would be, no, 3 × 5 × 6, because it's three statuses, and then you have 5 different goals, 6 different goals, and you have 5 different. So you have 90 different combinations of personal emails. So do you think that if I go ahead and send out an email to everyone and there are 90 different permutations and combinations of emails, do you think it would be amazing? All right, I still have some doubts about the exact number. Some people are saying no, but I still have some doubts about the exact number. I will get back to that. I think you have to do factorial if there are some people who are like really math geniuses here. So now we are going to go ahead and send out emails which are like, okay, lot of personalized emails. Okay, I will get back to the exact number later. But there is going to be a lot of personal emails that we are going to send. So how are we even going to send? So what do we need to do is that first we need to go and take the data from Typeform and we need to send it to ConvertKit. And that is where we need to use this tool called Zapier.com. We need to use this tool called Zapier.com. And what will happen is that here, I will go ahead and take the data from the form and I will go ahead and push it to. So I will go ahead and click on make a Zap. So this is one marketing automation, right? Okay, so before I show you how I take data from Typeform to ConvertKit, do you want to see how the personalized emails are? Yes. Excited to see how the personalized emails will be. So let me go ahead and show you how the personalized emails are. So what I'm basically going to do is that I'm going to send out an approval email to everybody who have applied for the program. All right. So what I have done is that I have taken all the data into, so I will just hide this for privacy. So what I have done is that I have taken all the data into a form. I have taken all the data and I have put it into a form and I have put it into my ConvertKit tool. So I do it real time where all the data automatically goes into ConvertKit using Zapier, which I will show you later. But now I have put all the data into a Google Sheet first, right? So here you can see that there are different combinations. You can see the different combinations. You have student who wants to start a digital marketing agency and his challenge is lack of guidance. Then you have then you have professional who wants to start an agency whose challenge is lack of whose challenge is procrastination. Then you have let's say you scroll down. Then you have an entrepreneur. Then you have an entrepreneur whose challenge is growing existing business and his challenge is lack of guidance and mentorship. So let's go ahead and take this person who is an entrepreneur. And let's go ahead and see how the email will be for her. Okay. So I'm going to preview. And in preview, I'm putting this here. Okay. So now I am putting this here. So this email says, you are an entrepreneur. Your goal is to grow existing business with the power of digital marketing. And your biggest challenge is lack of guidance and mentorship. And here you can see this is a single mail, but each email is personalized for each and every person that I am sending. So here you can see, since you are an entrepreneur, because she is an entrepreneur, I am talking about, since you are an entrepreneur, I think this program is very well suited for you. And this is what I am saying to her. And what is her goal? Her goal is to start and grow existing business with the power of digital marketing. And here I am going ahead and telling her that, don't worry, I have helped a lot of people to grow their business using the power of digital marketing. I have worked with Mercedes-Benz, Nikon, HDFC and all this. And then here, since you said your biggest challenge is lack of guidance and mentorship, I have made sure that I am available to you as a mentor to all the interns through the live classes for different topics. And every week we will have a live class, and after a few days there will be a Q&A session to help you complete the assignments. All right. So now imagine I go ahead and take someone else. Okay. So it is the same email. I go ahead and take someone else. So let's say I take a professional who wants to earn from blogging and affiliate marketing. I copy this and I paste it here. So let's see how this email looks for this person. And if somebody has filled their form, you can give me your email ID in the chat box here and I will put your email ID here and I will show you how the mail will look for you. So here you can see your internship program application is approved. You are a professional. All right. I got enough email IDs. I cannot handle everything. Please don't put your email ID anymore. So you are a professional. So what did this person say? Akash say? Akash said that his goal is to earn from blogging and affiliate marketing. And Akash said the biggest challenge is lack of guidance and mentorship. So I'm saying, since you are a professional, I'm writing that content blog. Your goal is to earn from blogging and affiliate marketing. So here it shows a proof of someone who made money from affiliate marketing in my previous batch of intern. And then it shows that, and then lack of guidance and mentorship. All right. So I will just take another email ID. So these people, I hope you are able to see my screen. Clear? Just type clear in the chat box if you're able to see my screen. Fantastic. So I took a mail ID from the chat box now, but problem, I got the mail ID. So here, so this person, Sweta Rani, she is saying that you are a student. Your goal is to become a digital marketing freelancer and consultant. Lack of implementation or practice to learn digital marketing. Right. So here it says, since you are a student, blah, blah, blah. And then you want to become a freelancer and consultant. And here it is showing a mail. It is showing a proof, which is saying that in my previous batch of interns, you can see that this freelancer has made 3.2 lakhs in just 2.5 months. And this person has made 2.3 lakhs. And then, since you said your biggest challenge is lack of implementation or practice to learn digital marketing, I think this program was just made for you. So now, for every person, based on what they have entered, I am sending a personalized email to them. And imagine if you have 5 into 5 into 5 into 5 combinations, you are talking about thousands of combinations of personalized emails that you can send. So how many of you think this is amazing? Just type amazing in the chat box if you think this is amazing. And now I will go ahead and tell you, how I do this. So there is an if-else condition. And when it comes to automation and when it comes to robotics, everything is an if-else statement, right? If this, then that. If this, then that. If this, then that. So I'm using ConvertKit for my email marketing. And in my ConvertKit, I have put some rules. So this is the email that I have written. So here, there are three variables. Subscriber.intstatus, which is the status. So if you look at this thing, so here you can see I have put a professional, entrepreneur, and student as the int status. And then I have put the int goal. What is their goal? And then I have put int wall. So now these are the fields. So now I say you are a subscriber.intstatus. Your goal is to subscriber.intgoal. And your biggest challenge is subscriber.intwall. Right? And so this will enter all the details there. So you are a student. Your goal is to do this. Your biggest challenge is this. But that's not it. I am doing some if-else conditions. So if subscriber.intstatus contains student, then show this content block. All right? And then else if subscriber int status contains professional, so it's not student, it's a professional, then you show this content block. Else if subscriber dot int status contains entrepreneur, then you show this content block. All right, I hope you are able to see my screen. My screen is clear. Just type clear in the chat box. Fantastic. All right, and then I am showing end if. All right, so I am not a coder, I am not a programmer, but I understand simple if-else statements. All right. So simple if-else statements is what you need. So now I am going like a set of if-else statements, and this is how that email is constructed. On the front end, it looks simple. For the person who is receiving that email, it looks very simple. Okay. And for here, once you set this up, which is like a very complex level of automation, then every person is going to get like a unique email. Right. So now we have ended if. So the first content block is over. And then the second content block may subscriber.intgoal contains start a new digital marketing company or agency. So that's what they wanted to do. So irrespective of whether they are a student, professional, or entrepreneur, if they have selected, I want to start a new digital marketing agency, then it will show this. Else if subscriber.intgoal contains grow existing business, then it show this. Else if subscriber.intgoal contains get a digital marketing job, then show this. Your goal is to get a digital marketing job. So here I have also linked to the interview that I did with Paul, who got a job for 4,300 euros per month in Germany. And he is basically, I did an interview with him and I'm putting it here. Else if subscriber int goal contains earn from blogging and affiliate marketing. Your goal is to earn from blogging and affiliate marketing. Excellent. The students of my internship program have success with affiliate marketing. So every person who is receiving this email feels like I'm receiving this email just for me, because I said I wanted to learn this, and he is saying that in internship program may you can learn this. So else if is basically instead of if else, you have if else if else if else if, and then you have end if, right? So if you just have two combinations, then you will put if and else. But if you have like 4 or 5 combinations, then you will put if else if else if else if and end if. So then you want to become a digital mentor, then this. If you want to become a freelancer or consultant, then this is the thing. And then you have the third content block. Third content block may you have procrastination as one of the challenges. And I tell people that if your problem is procrastination, this internship program will push you to take action, because with every assignment submission, you will earn. And this will have like a fear of loss. And then you will be able to go ahead and complete the assignments, and you will have like a, you will beat procrastination with this. So lack of quality and actionable content, lack of implementation or practice, lack of guidance, lack of community. For everything, I have a content block. So that's how this works, guys. That's how this works. And now it is clear for you. Is it clear? Just type clear in the chat box. And how many of you think this is wow? Just type wow in the chat box if you think this is wow. All right. Fantastic. So will you do me a favor if I ask you for a help? Will you do me a favor? Now that I have given you so much value, All right. So what I want you to do is that I want you to go ahead and take a selfie or go ahead and take a screenshot of this. And I want you to put out a tweet with a hashtag, or I want you to go ahead and share this on Instagram, and I will go ahead and give you some goodies. All right. So this much you can do, guys, for me. So if you liked this presentation so far, so I will go ahead and give my Twitter ID. And so that is the Twitter ID. So I'm giving you my Twitter ID. Twitter ID is @HiDeepak, and you put hashtag that was deep. And we have 3,000 people in the webinar today. If all of you go and tweet at the same time, then it will start trending. And I think we can start trending. That would be exciting. And you can go ahead and do an Instagram story also. And my Instagram ID is @hi.deepak. All right. So I've given you my Twitter and Instagram, which is Twitter is @hi.deepak. Hashtag that was deep. Instagram is @hi.deepak. So go ahead and put out a story. Give some feedback. What did you learn in today's marketing automation masterclass? Or you can go ahead and put out a tweet, just giving a feedback about the entire class. Can you do that for me? Yes. Just type yes in the chat box if you can do that for me. Fantastic. So for the free webinar that I am doing, I would like to get some traction for it. And I have shared it. I've shared my Twitter ID. I've shared my Instagram ID. I will just share it again. And don't just put amazing, great, or any one word sentences like that. Go ahead and write one line. Saying what did you feel about it? What did you learn? Was it mind bending? Was it, was it like unleashing the power of robots? I'll just share it with you again. So Twitter would be @hi.hideepak, HIGHDEPAK, hashtag that was deep. And Instagram would be @hi.deepak. All right, so let me go ahead and open Twitter and let's see what's happening there. So I see Subha has tweeted, Kaushik has tweeted. I think today's webinar was like supercharged. It was like mind bending for a lot of people. I think a lot of people will be like, for the first time, wow, this is like, this kind of personalization is like next level. So go ahead and put out a tweet and put out the hashtag also. And you can also take a screenshot, or you can take a picture of the notes that you have taken and you can put it there as well. So let's go ahead and have a look at some of the tweets that are coming in. Revolutionary learning. Good to attend free webinar. Super excited to learn a lot. Amazing session. Fantastic. So I'll give you 2 more minutes. Please tweet out. Please Instagram. So Mayank is saying mind-blowing webinar. Mind-boggling webinar. I think this is one of the best webinars I have ever done. So if you look at India trending, you might end up seeing some trends. You can also go ahead and take a picture of the mind map and share the mind map also if you want to share the mind map. You know, I'm giving you the mind map also. So you can take a picture of this and put it on Twitter. Come on, guys. I would like to have at least 1,000 tweets. And I have some bonuses for you towards the end. High power digital marketing tips. Mind-blowing webinar. Unleashing the power of robots. I think hashtag that was deep will start trending. Very good feedback on Twitter, guys. Today's webinar is so lit, Frank is saying. All right, thanks a lot, thanks a lot. And if you have done it, just type done in the chat box. If you have done tweeting or done putting it on Instagram, So a lot of people are asking for my LinkedIn ID. So if you are putting it on LinkedIn, let me go ahead and give you my LinkedIn ID. If you want to put it on LinkedIn. So linkedin.in/DeepakKanagaraju. So thanks for the message, guys. Thanks for the confirmation that it's done. I will go ahead and share this. And you can also post it on Facebook, tag me there. Let's go ahead and look at how much we have on Instagram. Oh, wow. We have 56 stories mentioning me. You can see that there are like 56 stories mentioning me. Thank you, guys. Crazy. And so let's go ahead and have a look at a few more things. And I hope you have applied for the internship program, right? Everybody has applied for the internship program. If you have not, I will send you the application link. And how many of you have already watched my lead generation guide? Have you watched my lead generation guide already? Because if you do not, okay, a lot of people are saying no, interestingly. And I will go ahead and show you my lead generation guide. So if you do not generate leads in the first place, then you cannot do marketing automation for it, right? Agreed? If you do not generate leads in the first place, you cannot do marketing automation for it. So by the way, for people who are staying until the end of the webinar, I'm going to give you a free course related to marketing automation. And if you want the certificate also, yes. So I will give you the certificate generation link. So what I have done is that I have, explained marketing automation along with Facebook ads in my lead generation video also. And I have explained some marketing automation tools as well. So I will go ahead and share that video with you. All right. So this is that video. And many people might have seen this video already. And this is like not a simple video, not for everyone. This is for people who really want to learn in depth. And this video is a 3 hours, 40 minute video. It's called the Ultimate Guide to Lead Generation. So I will go ahead and share the link with you here. And one more last thing before we continue with the rest of the session. Go ahead and click on this YouTube link. Put some comment here or whatever you think about the automation webinar. And please hit like on this particular video. Can you do that for me, guys? Yes. You can do that. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. So go ahead and click on that video. I've shared that link with you. And you can go ahead and hit like on this YouTube video. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and go ahead and save it. You can add it to your playlist or something. And if you want to put a comment here, you can put the comment here. So this particular video has techniques of B2B and B2C lead generation. And it talks about a lot of stuff. It talks about analytics. It talks about, I think you might have attended my lead generation webinar before. If you have attended my lead generation webinar, then you would understand the sales funnels. You will understand flywheel. You will understand how to generate leads, because without generating leads, you cannot do automation. And I will show you this automation now. You know, once we are done with this, I will show you how to create automations in ActiveCampaign. And then I will be showing you like a bunch of other stuff as well. All right. So by the way, congratulations, guys. You made me trend. Right now we are trending at 18. You can see we are trending at 18. And this is trending in India. And you guys made it. Thanks a lot. So we have got 3.2K likes, 1,307 comments. Fantastic. So let's look at some of the latest comments. Automation webinar is good, really helpful. So anyway, guys, go ahead and watch this particular video. And if you watch this particular video, you will understand a lot about lead generation. And my lead generation mastery course is coming soon. And once you have the lead generation mastery course, you will be able to learn a lot. And after the lead generation mastery course, I am going to launch my marketing automation course. So I hope you are excited about it. So I hope you understand that there is a lot to this course than... So I see a lot of people have already ordered the lead generation mastery course, and my lead generation mastery course is releasing on July 15th. And I hope you understand that there is a lot to learn in this lead generation marketing automation, and I will be releasing it and I will be letting you know about it. So before we end the webinar, I have saved the best for the last. So I will show you how my active campaign automation works. All right. So I will show you how my active campaign automation I have set up. So basically, you know, one of the things that I wanted to do was that I wanted to go ahead and send out a drip marketing sequence for people who learn digital marketing from me. And people subscribe for my free digital marketing sequence, and then they want to get my digital marketing videos on email. What I wanted to do was that I wanted to kind of do like a self-accelerated sequence. All right. So self-accelerated sequence basically means that, let's say I am starting to send emails, you know, let's say I'm starting to send emails. And once I'm starting to send emails, if people don't watch my video, I want to send them reminders. And if people watch my video, and instead of making them wait for 2 days, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to send them the next lesson. All right. How cool would that be? Let me know in the chat box. If you are creating a self-accelerated drip marketing sequence, where if people are watching the video, then immediately the next video is given. And if people are not watching the video, I'm continuously sending reminders for them to watch the video. So I will show you, this is not possible in ConvertKit, but this is possible in this software called ActiveCampaign. So ActiveCampaign is also something that I use. And here you can see, let's say you go ahead and subscribe at learndigitalmarketing.com for a free course. All right. If you go ahead and learn about it, if you go ahead and enter your name and email ID, and if you subscribe to my free course, then what I have done is that I have used an automation where this tag is applied. So this tag free DM is applied. And once this tag free DM is applied, then I am sending them the lesson one. So this is the lesson one, which contains the lesson one. So let's go ahead and open this and let's see what's inside. Okay, so this is the first email that I am sending. Welcome to the free digital marketing course. And I am giving a first lesson here. And imagine, and look at what I have done. I have also adding a tag. If people are clicking on the first lesson, then I'm adding a tag called free DM underscore lesson one. All right. So that is a tag that I am adding so that I know that people have clicked on that link. So once people have clicked on that link, then what will happen? That particular subscriber will get the tag free DM underscore lesson one. So that is how you use tags here. So now I'm waiting for 6 hours and I'm asking them to go and join my Facebook group. And a lot of people here would have joined my Facebook group already. You would have got an email. It is through the marketing automation. And then I am putting a condition. In the condition, I am asking, does the contact match the following conditions? Contact has tag free DM underscore lesson one. So if they have already clicked on lesson one and watched lesson one, the person will have the tag. Yes. Yes or no? Will the person have the tag? Yes. So if the person already has the tag after it checks, then what will happen is that it will go here. It will go and reach a goal. The goal is free DM lesson one done. Then it will send free DM underscore lesson two, right? Free DM underscore lesson two is basically the second lesson that is being sent. And if people are asking for certificate, I will throw you out of the webinar. The webinar itself is not over, and then you are already asking for certificate. How is this fair? And you are not here to get the certificate. You are here to learn first. First learn. I will go ahead and send you the certificate. I will send it to you on email. Relax. You will get the certificate. Please don't worry about it. All right. So don't be like a certificate hunter. All right. So here... So now it will go and check whether this particular person has free DM underscore lesson two. So now imagine that this person has got the email and then they have not clicked on the lesson one. They have got the email for lesson one, but then they have not clicked on the lesson one. Then what will happen? It will check whether the tag is there, and the tag is no, right? So once the tag is no, then it will set a set of reminder emails. All right. So I know that this will be a little bit confusing, and you might want to buy my marketing automation course to kind of completely understand it. But if you are brilliant enough to understand it, you will go ahead and just use it. So now for every lesson, what I have done is that I have set a set of reminder sequence. But if they watch that, then they go and attain the goal. And you know how I have configured the goal? I have configured the goal like this. So there is something called goal. So here, name is freedm_lesson1. And jump to this action when the goal conditions are met. So when will it jump to this action? If the contact has freedm_lesson1, then it will forget about all the reminder emails and jump here and get the lesson 2. And if this person has completed lesson 2, then it will attain the goal, which is lesson 2. And then it will go to lesson 3. And then if it has gone to lesson 3, then it will end the automation. So this is just for the first 3 lessons. So let me go ahead and zoom this out. And don't get confused. So this is how I have created the automation. Isn't this amazing? So this is just for 3 lessons. So what will happen is that if they see the lessons, then they will get the next email. If they see the lesson, they will keep getting the next email. So if they are subscribing today itself, they will get all the 3 lessons if they complete all the 3 lessons. But if they have not completed the lessons, it will keep sending the reminders, right? It will keep sending the reminders. So have you ever seen anything like this inside digital marketing? Have you ever seen anything like this explained by anyone? Nobody does this. You know, I go a little bit deep. All right. So this is how I have set up. So now inside ActiveCampaign, do you want to see how the particular person flows through the sequence? You want to see that? You want to see how a particular person flows through that sequence? So what I will go here is that I will go ahead and check for a tag. All right. I will go ahead and check for a tag, which is freedm_lesson2. So let's say we are looking at people who are completing freedm_lesson2. So these are the people who have completed lesson 2. All right. So now if I go ahead and look at these people, I can look at the entire sequence that they have gone through, and I will show you the entire map. So now you see what is the robot that is working for me. And this is what I call ghost in the machine. And I call it my ghost in your machine, because I am communicating to you. And but I'm not, like, you know, I could be going ahead and doing swimming or, having a good time with my friends or talking to my girlfriend or something like that. And then what will happen is that my ghost is continuously communicating to all the subscribers. That is why Digital Deepak, I'm not real Deepak. The digital version of me is communicating to people. So here I will go ahead and show you, let's say, automations. And here you can see, let's say, nurture free DM course. So let's go ahead and see this. So imagine if you do this for a client, do you think the client will be ready to pay you if you learn this? So this is something that I am teaching in my internship program, but this will be taught much more in depth in my marketing automation mastery course. So here you can see the exact path of this particular person. I know this is getting a little bit too intense for some people. You might want to watch the recording again, or you might want to go ahead and consume my marketing automation mastery course. But anyway, let's have a look at how this particular person traveled through the automation. That also I can see. He got the free DM tag applied, and then he went ahead and got an email, and then he went ahead and got another email. But you see, this person did not go ahead and watch the lesson. This person did not go and watch the first lesson. So instead of sending him the second lesson, first I want to keep giving reminders for the first lesson. So he goes here, and then I wait for 12 hours, and in this time he has completed. So he comes to the lesson 1 goal set, and then he gets the second lesson, and then he goes here, and then he comes here. and then he goes here, and then he comes here, and then he ends the automation. So you can map out the journey of each and every customer. So ActiveCampaign is the software. ActiveCampaign is the tool that will help you do this. And ActiveCampaign is kind of an enterprise tool. So if you are doing email marketing for a client, if you are doing marketing automation for a client, do you think the client will be ready to pay a huge price for you to set this up? He will pay you like whatever you want, right? So let's go ahead and look at another person who has done this. Let's go ahead and look at another email. So guys, this is not a free tool. There is a free trial of this tool, but this is not a free tool. So here you can see 63,000 people have completed lesson two. Let's go ahead and take this person, Monica. And let's see how this person has traveled through the automation. So it's like if you have read this Goosebumps novel, how many of you have read Goosebumps when you were a kid? Now there is this novel called Goosebumps. So basically what this novel does is that there are some 20 different endings for the novel. And it's like a scary novel. It's like a little bit of a kiddish novel. But there are like 20 different endings. So you choose different things. Like, okay, you are going to this temple. If you want to choose the first door, click this. If you want to run away, turn to this page. So it will say turn to this page, turn to this page. And then you go to that page. And from there it will go. So it's like multiple combinations, right? So here you can see this person. This person needed to have reminders for this. Without reminders, this person is not really involved. And I will just pause the chat for a while. So this person is not really involved. So this person got the first email, waited, got the second email. She did not complete the first lesson. I kept sending reminders for the first lesson. And then what will happen is that after sending a lot of reminders, I'm still going ahead and sending them the second lesson because I don't want to end the automation there. So it's going back here. She got the email and then I sent her a bunch of reminders. And then after she got here and then after she got here, ended the automation, right? So how is this, guys? How is this stuff? Mind blowing, mind bending. And this is just one time setup. If you just set this up one time, then you are done with it. If you just set this up one time, you are done with it. And I have set this up actually 2 years back. And once I have set this up 2 years back, it continuously keeps running and keeps communicating to all my audience. And a lot of people are like, how does this guy know that I have completed this lesson? I'm just tracking the links, guys. So, DM. So yeah, Nurture Free DM course. So this is the entire thing. So what I'm going to do is that, so what happens after lesson three? After lesson three, it goes to 4, 5, 6. And 4, 5, 6 scale, also I have set up like a separate automation. So it triggers, it puts a tag and it triggers. So now this is how the automation looks inside ActiveCampaign. And what I'm going to do is that I'm going to give you Zapier Mastery course for free. All right, I'm going to give you Zapier Mastery course for free. And Zapier Mastery course is my course, which is for marketing automation, which will, because today I did not end up having enough time to explain Zapier course to you. So this is my Zapier Mastery course. So this is my Zapier Mastery course. And here you can see there are multiple lessons in the Zapier Mastery course. So this I will give it to you for free. And this is like an offer for you guys for attending today's webinar. And I will give you a lot more courses for free. I will send this to you on email. And let me go ahead and send the link to the certificate generation on email. And I will also go ahead and share it with you on the chat box also. All right. So now, by the way, you guys have taken notes. Yes, you have taken notes. Fantastic. So let me go ahead and ask you. So what is your feedback on the Marketing Automation Masterclass today? Share the picture of the notes you took in today's webinar. So let me go ahead and ask this to you. So what you can do is that you can go ahead and share the notes that you have taken on the group. I will share the link with you. So go ahead and share the notes here. If you have taken the notes, I've shared the link with you. All right, so I see some really good notes being shared here. Fantastic, guys. So many, like, guys, don't post screenshots and all. Screenshots anyone can take. I said you have to take a pen and notebook and write. Okay, Bhavesh has given digital notes, which is fine. And go ahead and put a screenshot like this. So very good job by Nikhil. Very good job by Supriya. See, so many people have taken notes so sincerely. All right, so we are just scratching the surface, guys. We are just scratching the surface. There is actually a tool. So I showed you how to personalize emails, right? So there is actually a tool called Write Message, which will also help you personalize landing pages, and it will connect with your email marketing tool. Imagine how amazing it would be to personalize landing pages. There will be some 3,000 combinations of landing pages. So this tool also I'm going to cover in my Marketing Automation Mastery course. Today I don't have time to cover it. And this is also something that I'm going to share with you. All right. So isn't this amazing? How amazing it would be if you can personalize. How amazing it would be if you can personalize landing pages itself. You can personalize your web page. And you can start passive profiling people. And you can go ahead and start putting a poll on the web page. And you can start collecting data, personalize your email, and personalize your landing pages as well. Right? So Nagendra, just bump up the email again. I will have a look at it. Don't worry about it. All right. So I think we can end the webinar. Anything else to be covered? So how many of you want to get my... All right. I will not sell anything today. I'm not having any offers today. Zapier Mastery course, I will give it to you later. And just go ahead and look forward to my internship program, apply for it. And today I'm keeping the webinar sales free. I'm not asking anything of you. And I'm just asking you to go ahead and tweet. And I'm asking you to go ahead and put out tweet and help me train. So instead of giving you a sales pitch and instead of selling something today, I will go ahead and ask you to take a screenshot of this and put it on Twitter again. And put it on Twitter again. And if you put a few more tweets, if you feel like it, then put that was deep again. And let's reach trending top 10 in India. We are already at 18 last time I saw. So Twitter at HiDeepak, hashtag that was deep. And go ahead and put out a tweet and take a screenshot of this automation and tell me what you think about the automation. This is all I want from you. I will send you the certificate link, and I will also go ahead and send you the Zapier Mastery course link and the Digital Marketing Tools Mastery link. So are you ready to tweet again? So no sales pitch, guys, today. Sales pitch will be for some other webinar. I've made enough money this month selling. So let's keep it sales free. So Jayant is saying we'll implement this. Okay, I'm seeing a lot of people taking screenshot of this active campaign screenshot. Fantastic. Go ahead and you can also take your notes and put it on Twitter, but put the hashtag that was deep. So thank you, Nukula Manoj. Thank you, Raj Verma. Thank you, Arvind. Guys, put the hashtag also. Put the hashtag also. And let's see if we can trend on top 10 today. That's all I asked for you today. Nothing else. Okay, we are at 20. We are trending on number 20. You can see that we are trending on number 20. So you can see that we are trending on number 20. Hashtag that was deep. If you guys put out a few more tweets, then we will start trending on top 10. go ahead and put hashtag that was deep. I'm going to send you the certificate. I'm going to send you the Zapier mastery course. I'm going to send you the digital marketing tools mastery course. All right. So I think today's webinar was totally lit. And I see like this is awesome, looks complicated, but I believe it. It's so simple, simple logic. So now basically you are getting the robots to sell to you because you are sending personalized messages, right? Because you are sending personalized messages, people will listen to you. And one of the biggest problems that people have today, and guys, you can also do this subject line. Like I did some campaigns where, is this internship program suited for students, professionals, entrepreneurs? I did it in the subject line. And imagine you can also put city, you know, you can also put city. So if you put the city, like for example, I can do custom fields. So today I explained only tags, but I can also put custom fields. And if I put custom fields, I can put the city. And imagine I can put a title saying that, digital marketing internship in Mumbai, digital marketing internship in Chennai. And then I would say, no, you don't have it in Chennai. You have it online. You come online. So I can do that also, which I will explain in marketing automation. So imagine today, the biggest problem that marketers are facing is that they are not able to go ahead and have a good open rate, good response rate, because you are sending the same email to everyone, right? That's why the response rate is not good. Open rate is not good. But if you customize the subject line for each and every email you send, imagine how awesome it would be. Everybody will open your emails and the open rate will go up. And the biggest problem that marketers have today is that they are having a low open rate. And because of low open rate, their marketing campaigns are not working. So this is what I said. If you go ahead and personalize the communication, then people are going to, you know, have like a good response to it. And then if people pay you attention, then you can go ahead and convert that attention into a transaction. You can convert that into a sale. And this is not even by you, right? So now we have taken the power of sales. Then we took the power of marketing. And then we are putting the power of automation into it. So now with marketing automation, the power of sales is coming back into marketing. You know, that's how I would put it. In fact, I will go and tweet it out. All right, I will go and tweet it out. With the power of marketing automation, the power of sales is coming back into marketing. Right? And I will go ahead and tweet it. And please go ahead and retweet this. I will share the link. Go ahead and retweet this. I have never done this before on a webinar before. I think we will get a lot of retweets today. Like, how about getting like a bunch of retweets? Go ahead and click on it and retweet. With the power of marketing automation, the power of sales is coming back into marketing, because sales means it's one-on-one. Imagine that you are a salesman, and if you are like a door-to-door salesman, and imagine that you are going ahead and selling. Imagine that you are going ahead and selling a vacuum cleaner. And if you are knocking a door, and if an old couple opens the door, what are you going to tell? You are not going to give the same sales pitch to everybody out there, right? You are going to give a different sales pitch to everybody out there. So if an old couple is opening the door, what will you say? The salesman is going to say, hey, since you are an old couple and since you are selling I'm selling a vacuum cleaner, I think that it will be very difficult for you to clean the house manually, so buy my vacuum cleaner. That's what you are going to say as a salesperson. So as a door-to-door vacuum cleaner salesman, if you are going ahead and knocking on a door, and let's say a young couple opens the door and there are two kids running around the house, what are you going to tell today here? You are going to tell that, hey, use a vacuum cleaner because there are a lot of germs in your house which will not get cleaned by doing grooming. You have to use a vacuum cleaner so that your children are safe. So imagine here the salesperson is customizing the message according to who the person is. And if the salesperson is customizing the message, then that is the power of sales. You are like trying to make it customized. But now with marketing, if you want to reach thousands of people, then imagine that the vacuum cleaner is being advertised on newspaper or TV. With newspaper or TV, you cannot go ahead and identify who is this person. But with marketing automation, you can collect some details. Are you an old couple? Are you like a young couple? What is your age group? And then you are basically bringing back the power of sales back into marketing. Agreed? Is that analogy like, you know, is that analogy mind-blowing? So you are bringing back the power of sales back into marketing with the power of marketing automation. So you are having like a customized sales message, but you are going ahead and using the power of marketing to expand it. So guys, go ahead and retweet it. I just got 246 retweets so far. I need more. Get me 1,000 retweets today. Get me 1,000 retweets. I'm not selling anything. I'm just asking you to give me some social media traction. I think this much you can do. We have 2,400 people live. Guys, you don't use Twitter or what? Go ahead and tweet. Go ahead and tweet. So I feel like I have to end the session now because I'm getting very tired now. It's very late, but the marketing automation session has been very exciting. And I hope this was a very eye-opening session for you. And thanks a lot for attending today's webinar. And thanks a lot for all the social media activity. I will send you a bunch of free stuff. And I will do a lot of such free webinars, more informative webinars for you. And I hope the time was worth it for you. Having spent 1.5 hours, almost 1 hour, 45 minutes was the time worth it. And I hope you can become like crazy digital marketers. Yes. Fantastic. All right. So this is the kind of feedback I love. And this is why I'm doing these webinars. And for people who have joined my internship program, I will see you in my internship program. I'm also planning to do like a workshop on marketing automation and then a marketing automation mastery course. So I hope you can do that also. And that's about it. All right. And any other quote for today? Can you remember any other quote that we discussed today? I think I gave away a bunch of few quotes regarding marketing automation and regarding robots. So marketing automation unleashes power of robots. All you need to do is know how to communicate with these bots who are hiding inside the data centers and servers. All right. Oh, wow. From 13.8K followers, I've got like 14.1K followers already. All right, guys, I think enough of tweets today. Just one final tweet. Can go ahead and retweet it, like it, comment on it. And I think it is time to say good night. And it's time to wind off. So let's look forward to more exciting sessions like this. And that's about it. All right. So I will send you the recording. I have a recording of this webinar. I will send you the mind map. I will send you the application for internship program. I will send you the Zapier mastery course. I will send you the digital marketing tools mastery course, everything that you need. All right. So, wow. Even this tweet got like 100 tweets already, 80 tweets already. Fantastic. Thanks a lot, guys. So it has been like a social media festival today. All right. Good night. I love to stay around. I love to keep talking about marketing automation. But I better get back to people who might be expecting my time. Good night. Bye. And I will see you in the next webinar.